What's going on, guys, and welcome to a review. Actually, this is my first time reviewing an equipment, and it started when I went to Guitar Center to buy a microphone stand, and I saw this line array speakers on sale for $500, and it got me curious. So I tested it at the Guitar Center, and it sounded fine, so I figured I'd test it out on a real venue. So here we are. I'm doing a Christmas event today. Today is September 29. It's Saturday, 2018. So I already set up, if you can see here, let me move the camera real quick. I already set up the other one. It looks like this. So just looks like a Bose L1, kind of. And I don't have any experience of any of these line arrays. I always had the 15-inch tops and 15-inch bottom speakers for from EV. So this is my first time testing out the line array, actually. It took me about, well, less than a minute to install this. So it just clicks in, actually, when you install it. And then it's also the middle one and then the bottom one. So it comes in three pieces. I got one here. That's not assembled yet, so I'm going to show you how I'm going to assemble this and see how fast. Let me see if I can actually take a good video of it. So it's like that. It's like so. Like I said, it comes in three pieces, two smaller speakers and subwoofer. It's a 12-inch subwoofer, I think. I don't have a lot of information about this. Like I said, I'm just testing it out for today's event and see how it holds up. I mean, I'm not expecting a lot from these speakers because they're $500. I mean, you know. First one clicks in, easy enough. Just move the camera real quick, and there's that. Okay, second one. Yes, oops, other way around. Clicks right in like this, and ta-da, we got it. Like I said, less than a minute. So you can also play it through Bluetooth. I got the other speakers all set up for Bluetooth, and let's just play something. Okay. I'm not sure if you can judge it by its volume. I am about 50, 60 feet from the speakers, and they're okay for, I'd say, cocktail hour, ceremony. Obviously, this will rock ceremony. Just lower the volume there. So yeah, but for reception, for dances, I'm not sure if I'm gonna be using them. I don't know yet, so. We'll find out. What I observed from when I tested it in my basement is that I don't hear much lows. I actually brought my EV EKX 15-inch subwoofer that's on the side there to help with the lows. We'll go from there. We'll take a video again later on, how they're holding up. You better not cry, you better not pout, I'm telling you why, Santa Claus is coming. Alright guys, so I'm done setting up both the speakers, everything is set up pretty much, and I just want to show it to you. The MLS900 has three channels, and the third channel is for Bluetooth, as you can see here, and also for left and right DRS. Here you go. So I am on channel one, it's online. The thing that I noticed is that if it's online, I need to actually put it in the max volume here. Max volume here for line. If I have it on guitar, it's a lot louder, or mic, it's a lot louder, but I'm not using a mic or a guitar there. I'm using a line going to my DDJ-1000 here. So I have to look it up if I should be using mic. Obviously, I should not be using guitar anyway. So we'll go from there. So I just wanna show it to you how it sounds like. This venue can fit up to around 200 people. So I'm gonna play a Christmas song here, and I'll do my best to project the sound that I'm hearing for you guys. I'm using a TacStar microphone for my camera, so I hope, I'm not sure if it's gonna do any justice, so just hear it for yourself. Honestly, it is pretty loud. I mean, seriously, man. For a reception, I think it can hold up. If you have a guest of like 200 people and have a basketball court size of a ballroom, I mean, I think you're gonna be fine. So my review with the Harbinger MLS900, they actually did great. They did great for that event, and like I said, I needed some help with the bass, so I included an EV subwoofer. Other than that, everybody complimented the sound. I was not missing any highs or lows, obviously, and I'll see what happens on my next event. I'll be using them again, and we'll see what happens. But right now, I really liked it. All I can say is that for the money, $500 per speaker, a pair is $1,000. I mean, it's really worth it. I mean, the EV Evolves are currently priced at $1,599, so $1,600, and the Evox 12 are $2,400. The Evox 8 is around $1,400, I think. So for a pair of those, like $3,000, and you might not be getting as loud of a sound that's coming from an Evox from the Harbingers, but you know, add a 15-inch or 18-inch subwoofer, and there you go. You got a very nice setup there. It's very easy to use too. Takes about 30 seconds to install it, and you're good. And if you are doing a ceremony, you can just use the Bluetooth. You don't need a laptop. It's very easy. Or if you're in a cocktail hour, it's the same thing. Just use Bluetooth. That's what I did earlier. While I was mingling with the guests, I'm using Bluetooth to run my speakers. It's really easy. So that's all I can say right now. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. Other than that, out of five, I'm giving it a 4-star. I'm giving it a 4-star because of the price, and the sound is not as bad. A lot of DJs are scared of buying cheap Guitar Center products, but hey, give it a try. And before you judge it, use it first, and then, you know, and then make a video of it or review it. Let me know in the comments below. So thank you, and have a good night.